Sturgeon were swimming in the Fraser River when dinosaurs were walking the land, meaning they have survived as a species for over 65 million years. They naturally occur in only a handful of rivers in North America, and by the 1990s, this ancient fish had all but disappeared from the Columbia, Nechaco, and Fraser rivers in British Columbia.
White sturgeon are the largest species of fish in North America. The common feature with those was all those rivers had major habitat alterations through things like dams. So what we were seeing was just a lack of juvenile sturgeon being produced, and aging populations with no reproduction. So part of the task was sorting out really what was going on.
British Columbia's Man in Motion is an avid fisherman. His concern led to stakeholders across the province joining forces to solve the mystery of the missing sturgeon.
Rick Hansen approached the provincial government with a proposal to tag more fish and do a market capture study where we would actually be able to assess whether it's getting good recruitment of juveniles.
There was a lot of excitement generated amongst anglers, stakeholders, NGOs in First Nations, and we actually saw the formation of the Fraser River Sturgeon Conservation Society.
The goal is to have the sturgeon be at a strong enough population that they can just sustain themselves.
We started a fairly ambitious program in the mid-1990s, the first province-wide assessment of white sturgeon. We started to understand how populations were structured.
But research was just one part of the plan. To ward off threat of extinction, they began rebuilding habitats and created a captive breeding program.
We call it conservation aquaculture. We raise the progeny in a captive situation, get them past that critical phase, and re-release them into the environment.
The program has tagged over 46,000 sturgeon, and we get information back from it by scanning it.
We've been tracking them every year since, so now we have proof that some of these juveniles are actually surviving. And there is natural spawning occurring as well.
We've learned so much since the late 1990s. We've got all that effort going towards it, and I got to believe that we're going to have a positive outcome of this.
There has been ups and downs in the relationship between this program and various First Nation and sport fishing groups. But it's like a marriage. It's a long-term commitment, and you have to keep working at it or it doesn't survive.